state of Indiana, you can travel around looking for the state pie, the sugar cream.
I don't mind it coming in
if
late.
If you're lucky, you'll end up on Highway 31 near Atlanta, Indiana, where Lisa's Pie Shop is often a stop for pie lovers.
Passed through here last week. I seen the pie shop, and we just had to stop.
I'm making two shows for PBS right now. A few good pie places and a few great bakeries. This is the pies DVD. I think people might be surprised at how small the team is. Four of us sort of gathered the footage, and then Kevin Conrad is the editor, and then there's Read Connolly, who does the music.
It's pretty good.
I've been playing with a band called the Beagle Brothers, but I've always been making solo music. I see myself as a musician, but currently work for Pittsburgh Public Schools. I do tech support for them. These two documentaries, this is the first time that I've ever had a real good opportunity to show my solo music.
I first learned about the Beagle Brothers from Paul CDs, and one of the guys there in the shop, Bob, I think, told me about the Beagle Brothers, and I really loved them, and I started to go see them.
I didn't grow up around here. When I was learning about who Rick Sebak was, you know, I discovered pretty early on that he's a local celebrity. It turned out that my ex-wife, her grandma was best friends with his mom. So I sort of just took it upon myself to...
One day he said, let's go get dinner, and so we did.
You want to go to Gooski's in Polish Hill? It's like one of my favorite bars. He's like, oh, I've never been there. And I have no idea how hard it is to find a place that Rick has never been to in Pittsburgh, but somehow I found one and we just hit it off really well.
He approached me actually and said, I'd be interested in, you know, composing some music for your shows. Why not? Actually, I think I said to him, I was a little scared. I thought, well, maybe we should try you with on one of the shows, one of the two shows. And I think he was sort of ballsy and said, no, I'd like to do both.
The first thing I do with Rick is I watch the scene that he wants the music under, and we get the exact length.
Passed through here last week.
So basically, that's where we would probably go out, but it could go long.
Rick is very specific about wanting hard stops.
I don't think there's any rules about how you do this. I think we were both a little scared, and I think he was getting nervous that we hadn't done anything yet, but I don't think about the music till pretty late in the process.
He wanted very concise pieces of music. In a lot of cases, I was using one song that I wrote, but there are several different variations on it. I think different instruments create different ideas.
In my shows, we use music with the transition from story to story.
Rick doesn't speak the language of music, but we were able to communicate together. So if he said, oh, this is a French bakery, that made me think of using accordion.
The first story is about a little bakery in Syracuse that makes Italian bread, and I thought the accordion would sound Italian, and there's probably a little more ukulele in the pie show. Not for any reason, it's just that's the way things worked out.
For recording the show, I used all instruments I had laying around the house. So I used acoustic guitar, 12-string guitar, piano, accordion, acoustic lap steel, and electric lap steel, and ukulele. And I would just layer it piece by piece. So some of the songs were one instrument. There were other songs that had five instruments.
I think it worked out really well. And you know, I'm totally happy.
I was challenged every step of the way, but I'm thrilled with how it turned out. And it was actually not as difficult of a process as I thought it would be.
When you watch the shows, it's good to like just listen to the music.
Now I know if I'm traveling, I'll look to the show and seek out these bakeries.